dear family and friends. We have gathered here today at the invitation of Sabrina and Jerome to celebrate the joy of their wedding. Now this outward celebration is a promise of hope between two people who love each other sincerely, who honor each other as individuals, and who wish to unite their lives and share their futures.
Friends and family, they help us through the highs and the lows of life. They celebrate with us when things are good. Then they stand by us through sad and difficult times. Sometimes we forget to tell those we love how much they mean to us and how much their unconditional love and support brings joy into our lives. So it's beautiful that today Sabrina and Jerome can show their love and commitment.
I'm talking about that moment where you decided that this person would be the one who you spent the rest of your life with. I mean, where you committed yourself to this idea of a lifelong union. It was these moments more where you answered that question by choosing to commit yourself to a profound intimacy. And your answer to these moments brings something incredible to your soul. Both of you willing to truly let someone in so that they see everything. Your quirks and your uniqueness. And then you feel and experience the depth of their love. You're never able to go back to life without intimacy. You find freedom and peace to be who you are. You find encouragement and affirmations. And I believe that's why we're here today. That the potential and happiness of your marriage will far outweigh anything you could obtain on your own. And then there's this comfort in knowing that you have a partner who's willing to sacrifice for you as much as you are for me. Now we, as your family and friends, we hope for you a relationship that never forgets the value you see in each other. The value that's stirring your heart in the first place to commit to sacrifice one another.
Always being open and honest with you.
Sorry, if I wear the jacket, I probably cannot finish the speech. happy days. I have two beautiful daughters, one handsome son, and one very cute dog. No expectation. All you can do is wish, and very proudly wish. And today, one of my wishes come true. Three more to go. But and Sabrina not just got married. I think she really, really find the perfect match. I'm not saying that because I'm her dad. The last 3 years, they come to my house almost every day. I don't know why, but they can. You know, I wish I could speak Mandarin. I could use 24 different words to describe it. But no matter 24 words or 48 words, they all translate into they are the perfect match. You know, I think you two should really treasure your marriage, your relationship, and the family you built together. I know someday, Jerome, you and Sabrina will stand here and talk to your children in their marriage. Of course, that's another wish of mine. Shouldn't have said that. Okay, I know all you just wish to see the steak and the dinner on your table. So I'll cut my speech short and thank everybody for coming and enjoying the dinner and join tonight. Thank you. Appreciate it. Bye-bye.
Is the mic on?
It's close.
Okay. And we're very happy to see you all here. Mr. Chen and I have been waiting a long time for the door. At first we thought when Jerome was arriving that we were going to have a girl. So I think I'm being Jennifer. But towards the end, the doctor says, not so fast. You got a boy, I said, great. So when Jerome arrived, he was a big kid, 9 pounds, 2.5 pounds.
Wow.
When he cried in the infant room, all the other babies cried after that. He was always hungry. Anyway, we have images of him as a kid. I gave him a small tennis racket, and he would crawl around with it, pop, pop, pop. And when he could stand up, when he was about 1 year old, Johnson and I taught him how to hit the ball. So he was hitting a nerf ball against the front door, and he would play until midnight. One time I saw Mr. Chan sitting on the floor with a finger on the switch. This image is right here, just sitting next to Jerome. Time for bed. On weekends, we let him go beyond midnight. Anyway, that was the early part of his life. So all in all, we are happy that we have Jonathan to look after him. And when he was going through school, he would tell the other kids, if you do anything to me, I have a bigger brother. So check him off his back. Yeah. When Sabrina and Jerome were dating, we found
I met Jerome was when my dad and I, we had tickets to a Lakers game. And I told Sabrina, we have tickets to a Lakers game. We have two extra tickets. Would you like to bring a friend? She asked me, well, who are we playing? Well, we're going to State Warriors. I said, oh, I know exactly who to bring. I said, okay, cool. You know, bring a friend, bring someone along, be cool. And out walks this tall guy named
everyone that's here tonight. Sabrina is just a perfect match for you. I mean, I've seen it from day one. You guys are fantastic together. I think back to growing up and all like the fun arguments we've had. Who's the better running back? Who's the better center? Who's the better point guard? But we both
明天走了，因为六点了，因为强力士礼拜一要上班，然后三个人坐一部车来的，开车他开嘛，因为他跟那个姐夫两个人轮流开就比较好，
对，
我是姐夫一个人开，我就很辛苦，然后他住进办公室，因为。